Hi everyone, in this video we're going to go over how to make your dynamic data visualizations, or charts and graphs, more accessible. We'll start with briefly covering the accessibility basics your charts and graphs should meet. We'll spend most of the time going over 5 additional strategies you can use to make your visualizations more usable and a more similar experience for non-sighted users. The great part about data visualizations is each data point comes together to communicate a trend or opportunity, helping us make informed decisions. For example, in this line chart, it's easy to see that Apple sales are going up. The issue is, data visualizations aren't as easy to glean insights from for non-sighted users. Non-sighted users rely on a screen reader announcing one data point at a time. This can make it more difficult to put each data point together to make a trend, especially when there are several data points. The start of dynamic visualization accessibility is in the basics. The chart or graph should follow accessibility color use requirements, which are the contrast between colors are at least a 3-to-1 ratio with adjacent colors, and colors shouldn't be the only way to communicate information. Next, it should be navigable using only a keyboard, and consider how a screen reader announces each data point. For more detail on these and examples, check out our article in the resources below. Now, even if a data visualization is technically accessible with a keyboard and screen reader, it still might not be a similar experience for non-sighted users because they go through one data point at a time, making it difficult to come to conclusions about the data, especially when there are several data points or more complex visualizations. We're going to go through 5 strategies that aren't requirements, but can make your data visualization more usable and accessible for non-sighted users. The first is to give the tabular data. This is something all data visualizations could start doing. It gives an alternative way to view the data, and often tables are easier to navigate with a screen reader. Here's an example. This is Pope Tech's errors by group bar graph. Right now, I'm in the chart view, but I can select the table view in the top right. Now, users can choose one that works best for them or go back and forth as needed. The next way to make data visualizations more accessible comes from Thomas Watkins' presentation, Getting to the Core of Data Visualization Accessibility, which is linked below. It's to introduce the visualization with HTML headings. This makes it so as the user scans the page, either visually or with a screen reader, they're also getting prepared to view the data. It is especially useful for screen reader users since they usually navigate pages by headings. Here's a basic structure you can follow for a dashboard with multiple data views on it. The heading 1 is the dashboard title. All heading 2s are viewer widget titles, and heading 3s are filter, parameter set, or legend titles. The heading structure can change depending on the situation, as long as it is preparing the user to interact with the data. Here is an example of Pope Tech's dashboard page. The heading 1 is dashboard, which communicates the page as an overview of information. The heading 2s are the view or widget titles, automated scorecard, most common issues, manual scorecard, and accessibility focus. Each of these gives a brief summary of the information in the widget, preparing the user to interact with it. The third possible strategy also comes from Watkins, and it is to give captions that include the graph title, the chart or graph type, the goal of the visualization, how to read or navigate it, and a summary of important trends. Yes, this sounds like it will be long, but that's okay. The goal is to provide clarity, not be brief. Let's write a caption for Pope Tech's errors by group bar graph. I'd start with the graph title, which is errors by group. Next is the type and goal of the graph, which could be, is a bar graph giving the total errors and alerts per page by group. Now I can give some information on how it is structured, like the 4 groups from top to bottom are Pope Tech Main, Pope Tech, Demos, and Data. Lastly, I'd add a summary of trends. Altogether, the summary could be, errors by group is a bar graph giving the total errors and alerts by group. The 4 groups from top to bottom are Pope Tech Main, Pope Tech, Demos, and Data. Here are the insights from the group with the most errors per page to the group with the least. Demos has the most errors per page at 24. It has 19 alerts per page. Data is close behind with 23 errors per page. It has the most alerts per page at 25. PopTech Maine has 17 errors per page and 15 alerts per page. PopTech has the least errors and alerts per page at 3 and 4. The roadblock with captions is they need to be automatically created as the dynamic visualization changes with the data. With advances in AI or even conditional logic, summaries like these could become more common. The next way to make your visualization more usable is to have goal-oriented data visualizations. Busy dashboards that might look beautiful with lots of colors, movement, and data points can make it hard for any user to know where to focus. Instead, make your visualizations goal-oriented. Then they're built to answer a business question. When dashboards are made of several views that are goal-oriented, it's easier to make accessible. Plus, it's easier for all users to make data-driven decisions. Lastly, use filters so users can customize the view. Filters help users choose what data they want to look at, and this freedom can help some users customize the data in a way that makes it easier for them to navigate and understand it. Let's review. Data visualizations are meant to convey trends based on multiple data points coming together. When a user can only hear one data point at a time, it's difficult to pick up on these trends. To help all users experience a dynamic data visualization similarly, we must consider both accessible interfaces and strategies to make it more usable. To meet basic accessibility, the visualization should have at least a 3-to-1 color contrast ratio between adjacent colors and shouldn't rely on only using color to communicate information. It should also be fully navigable using only a keyboard, and a screen reader should announce each data point in a way the data point makes sense. These make it more navigable, but it might not be a similar experience, especially for non-sighted users. There are 5 possible strategies you can use to make your data visualizations more usable. First, provide tabular data. Second, introduce the information with headings. Third, if possible, provide a caption that has the graph title, type, and goal. Also add information about how to read or navigate it and a summary of the trends. Fourth, design goal-oriented views. And fifth, use filters so users can customize their view for their needs. Now, everything can come together to make a more accessible and usable experience for all types of users.